Bila kau berduka dan kau putus asa, ku fahami apa yang kau rasa. Di sini adaku, bukankah aku temanmu? Yang ku ingin hanyalah senyumanmu. Biar kegelapan menghilang dan cahaya terus menerangi. Let me see you smile, let me see you laugh. Let your worries go away and never come again. I wanna smile with you, I wanna laugh with you. We never know all the good that a simple smile can do. Whoa. Putus asa, ku fahami apa yang kau rasa. Di sini adaku, bukankah aku temanmu? Yang ku ingin hanyalah senyumanmu. Biar kegelapan menghilang dan cahaya terus menerangi. Let me see you smile, let me see you laugh. Come again. I wanna smile with you. I wanna laugh with you.
Dan Perdana Menteri Malaysia Mahathir Mohamad hari ini berkunjung ke Indonesia, rencananya sebentar lagi juga. Tadi Anda melihat sudah tiba, kunjungan ini akan menjadi kunjungan kenegaraan pertama setelah ia kembali menjabat sebagai kepala negara. Ya, Mahathir Mohamad terpilih menjadi Perdana Menteri Malaysia kembali pada pemilihan umum 10 Mei lalu. Ia mengalahkan petahana Najib Razak yang sudah berkuasa selama hampir 10 tahun. Mahathir Mohamad tidak asing dengan Indonesia, justru sangat akrab dengan Indonesia. Ketika ia menjadi Perdana Menteri tahun 1981 hingga 2003, beberapa kali bertemu dengan Presiden Indonesia kala itu. Ya, kita lihat Presiden Joko Widodo bersama Ibu akan menyambut Perdana Menteri Malaysia Mahathir Mohamad yang dalam kunjungannya kali ini ditemani oleh Siti Hasmah. Siti Hasmah Muhammad Ali dan Kunjungan Mahathir Mohamad akan berlangsung selama 2 hari, hari Kamis dan hari Jumat. Kunjungan ini merupakan yang pertama kalinya. Sebelum ke Indonesia, Mahathir Mohamad juga sempat berkunjung ke Jepang untuk memperkuat hubungan bilateral kedua negara.
Dan laporannya seterusnya tentang Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad pulangkan pingat sebelum Sultan Selangor tarik balik gelaran. Itu yang kami bawakan daripada tindakan Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad dan isterinya Tun Dr. Siti Asmah Mohamad Ali memulangkan pingat yang diterima kepada Sultan Selangor.
Perdana Menteri Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad menerima anugerah khas kelestarian Chancellor University Sains Malaysia USM di Istana Aroh Perlis malam tadi. Anugerah disampaikan Raja Perlis Tuanku Syed Sirajuddin Putrajamalul Lail kepada Tun Dr. Mahathir sebelum berlangsungnya Majlis Santapan Negeri sempena sambutan ulang tahun keputeraan Baginda ke-76. Turut berangkat hadir Raja Perempuan Perlis Tuanku Tengku Fauziah Tengku Abdul Rashid, Raja Muda Perlis Tuanku Syed Faizuddin Putrajamalul Lail dan Raja Puan Muda Perlis Tuanku Lailatul Shahrin Akashah Khalil. Hadir sama pada majlis itu Tun Dr. Siti Hasmah Mohamad Ali dan Naib Chancellor USM Profesor Dr. Faisal Rafiq Mohamad Adikan. Terdahulu, Tuanku Syed Sirajuddin berkenan menyampaikan darjah dan pingat kebesaran negeri Perlis kepada 19 penerima pada istiadat penganugerahan yang berlangsung sempena ulang tahun keputeraan Baginda di Istana pagi semalam.
I have always regarded China as a neighbor, a good neighbor, and also as a very big market for whatever it is that we produce. So Malaysia is a trading nation. We need markets. We can't quarrel with such a big market as China.
There's this perception, though, it's been 40 days since you took over power. People are still wondering about your views on China. Would it be unfair to say that you are perceived as anti-China? Is that an unfair perception?
No, there are certain things, of course, which were done, which was not to Malaysia's advantage or even good for Malaysia. We welcome foreign direct investment from anywhere, certainly from China. But when it involves giving contracts to China, borrowing huge sums of money from China, and the contract goes to China, and China contractors prefer to use their own workers from China, use everything imported from China, and even the payment is not made here, it's made in China. So we gain nothing at all. That kind of contract is not something that I welcome. The other thing is that they develop whole cities, very sophisticated cities, very.
Perdana Menteri Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad dianugerahi Nishan E. Pakistan atau Order of Pakistan, anugerah awam tertinggi negara itu yang disampaikan oleh Presiden Pakistan Dr. Arif Alivi. Anugerah itu diberikan atas sumbangan beliau kepada Pertubuhan Bangsa-Bangsa Bersatu PBB, Pertubuhan Kerjasama Islam OIC dan ASEAN. Nishan E Pakistan adalah anugerah awam tertinggi yang diberikan Kerajaan Pakistan untuk perkhidmatan tertinggi.
Sementara itu, Perdana Menteri Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad hari ini dianugerahi Grand Cordon of the Order of the Paulownia Flowers daripada Maharaja Akihito dari Jepun. Penganugerahan yang tertinggi dari Jepun itu diberi berdasarkan sumbangan besar beliau dalam usaha mengukuhkan hubungan dua hala. Majlis penganugerahan itu berlangsung di Imperial Palace di Tokyo jam 9.45 pagi waktu tempatan. Anugerah itu adalah pemberian tertinggi yang diberi kepada pemimpin luar bagi sumbangan terhadap hubungan dua hala antara negara-negara berkenaan dengan Jepun di samping sumbangan mereka kepada rantau ini. Dr. Mahathir adalah pemimpin ketiga dari Asia yang menerima anugerah berprestij ini selepas bekas Perdana Menteri Singapura mendiang Lee Kuan Yew dan bekas Perdana Menteri India Manmohan Singh.
The only people whom we like to come to Malaysia, but the people who have done a lot of wrong things, if we consider them as unfit to visit Malaysia, that is our right.
But then, even if what you believe you are saying to be true, why do you think these reactionary racist politics is the way to finding a road to the two-state solution that you so desire.
How's that?
So your policy is in support of the two-state solution, but why do you think these kind of remarks help achieve that goal instead of finding some kind of constructive way of building that solution?
I don't know about constructive way. This is a government that doesn't care about the opinions of others. That's why they keep on committing war crimes all the time. So what I say is what I have a right to say. But if they don't like it, they can say they don't like it. I don't care.
But it's, with all due respect, it's not about caring. It's about creating a climate of politics that isn't anti-Semitic or racist. And do you think that these kind of statements aid that process or hinder the process of achieving a solution?
Achieving?
A solution.
A solution should be, should go down to finding out the reasons for the behavior of the Jews and of the Arabs. This did not happen 70 years ago, did not happen. Until you create the state of Israel, you took Arab land and gave to Israel, and the Arabs were expelled from Palestine. Is that right? But the people supported. I am surprised that reasonable Democrats keep on supporting the act of seizure of foreign land to create a nation for somebody.
I think on that point it would be a good time to open up the floor to audience questions. I'll take the hand at the very far back.
Thank you, Prime Minister Mahathir Mohamad. I'm from Australia. My question is, how do you see Australia and Malaysia cooperating in the future on the bilateral and the multilateral level?
Well, we consider Australia as a friendly country. Of course, like all countries, sometimes they say things which are not palatable to us, and sometimes we say things which are not palatable to them. I mean, while you are friends, sometimes you have a need to tell a friend that you have done something wrong. If you tolerate everything that somebody does because he is a friend, then you are no friend. So we tell Australia that because they decided to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, that will only cause a lot of people to get very angry, and some of them might become terrorists because of that. That's what I told the Prime Minister. It's up to him to do what he likes, of course. He has a right. But what I think will happen is that you are causing a lot of people to feel very angry, and they are frustrated. And when they cannot do anything, they go and blow themselves up in your country. That's what will happen.